Maddie had her babies. She had a boy and a girl. And I think the other two are in labor.
Hey guys, so Maddie had two lambs. We came inside for an hour or two and Pebbles started going into labor. She looks like she's having complications, so we are going out right now to go help her.
Okay, got it. Here, I got a towel right here. Yep, quick. Still light. Hold. Yes, thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Okay, Pebbles. I'm so sorry, Mama.
Welcome to the world, little one. Oh my goodness.
Oh, I hope hope we didn't hurt your Mama too much. Yeah, she should be okay. Good girl, Pebbles.
Hey, Pebbles.
Oh, yeah. It's alive, guys. Sid, look at its little things on its hooves.
What?
So that's so that they don't tear the uterus when they're...
Can I dry it off?
Yeah, that's okay.
Good.
Oh, yep, go ahead and let her lay down. Yeah. Oh, it's tiny, but it's big. It's a little boy.
Oh, that kind of stinks.
Yeah. Well, yeah. It's okay.
Think that's the only one?
I do. So, I'm going to get her some green, hon.
Yep.
I'm going to change water for everybody again. Oh. It's so weird, the tail. Okay. Let's let her try to lick it off, okay, Sid? Here, take the towel, please.
Oh, it's brown, black, and white.
This is your baby. Yeah.
Dang it.
Can you do something?
No, it's okay, Mama. Look at it. Right down there. Hey, that's your baby.
Okay, here's the small.
Okay, let's try. Well, nice and quiet if possible, okay?
What?
Nice and quiet if possible. Okay. Can you hold that for me?
She going into the house?
Yeah, she's going to get water, I think. You're okay, Mom. You're okay. Yeah. You're okay. It's all okay. Yep. This is your baby. Can you lick it off for me?
That was traumatic, wasn't it?
The halter might be kind of stressing her out even more.
Should we take it off?
What?
Should we take it off?
Well, that's what I'm thinking. Yeah. But it gives me something to hold on to.
Mm-hmm.
But I need her to take... For baby, first and foremost, so that I'm here in bottle feeding one. There you go. Yeah. Can you lick your baby off for me?
Huh? It's really pretty. It's really pretty. I know. You don't like to be petted. I know. Come on. Look at your baby. Lick it up. Lick it up. Your baby, can you lick it off? Please.
It's not fair to have one of your sisters have to freeze your baby for you. Because you're so flighty.
Yep. So it's the next morning, and we left the barn at about midnight last night, and we just let everybody sleep. I made sure that Pebbles' little ram is nursing off of her, and I do have a few concerns because he would be nursing, and then she would kick him off. She'd let him nurse for just a few seconds, and then she'd kick him off. So I just want to check on everybody now and make sure, from what I can see, she still is kind of doing that. So I want to make sure that he's actually getting stuff to drink and he's warm enough because it is cold. We have lots of snow outside again. And just want to make sure that he's doing okay and then the other two are doing okay as well.
Hey, Mama. How's your little boy doing?
Look at
you still have all that. Did you know that? There you go.
Now Pebbles is our flightiest of the lambs, or of the sheep, and so she is not very handleable. No, I don't know. She's just very flighty, and so I'm just trying to show her that we're not going to hurt her, even though pulling that lamb last night did hurt. I'm just trying to show her that we're not going to hurt her, and then we're not going to hurt her baby, and his mouth is wet and nice and warm, so that means that he's been drinking. Let me see if she'll let me grab him. I'm noticing on the security camera that he's only nursing off of one side, and so that's the side that I was forcing him to nurse off of last night. So I do want to try to hold her and make sure that that plug is emptied and that he's able to nurse off of the other side. But she is pretty flighty. I'm actually afraid she's going to jump up on this rock wall and try to get out of here. So I'm not quite sure if I will be able to do this or not. It might just have to be something that we slowly work up to. And hopefully we can get him nursing off of both sides. Okay. So the plan is, these guys seem to be doing great. I haven't checked on them yet, but just from everything I'm seeing, they're up and nursing all the time. Hi, Maddie. Maddie is doing a great job. And so we're going to actually take these guys and move them to a different jug
The reason why I didn't do that last night is because we don't have a camera there. And so the plan is that when it warms up a bit, we'll move these guys to a different jug, and then we will take Pebbles and her little baby and put them here, and then we can see them off of the security camera and make sure that they're still doing okay and everything, but then they can have a bigger area because I don't want them to be in this little tiny cramped area for too much longer. Okay, so this is her ram. You can see his big old forehead here. That's what was getting stuck last night. But he is so sweet, and he's doing pretty good. His ears are just a little chilly, but he feels warm, and his mouth is nice and wet. Yeah. Hey, Mama. Come on. Good job, Mama. Yeah. Did you hear him calling you? Oh, you're okay. You're okay. Yeah, his belly feels like it has some feet in it. There we go. Get that out of there from last night. Huh. You're okay. Can we get him to nurse off of you? I really would like to try. This is the side that I need him to nurse off of, so this layout is actually good, as long as she doesn't go crazy here. Oh, good girl. Oop, that's what we wanted to avoid. You're okay, you're okay, you're okay. You're okay. Yeah, there's no milk on this side. Why is that, huh? There we go. Oh, yeah. There's no milk in that side because your little guy's eating, huh? You're doing good. He seems to have a nice full belly. Oh, he's so pretty. Yes, he is. There you go. There you go. He's doing great. There you go. See? Yeah, good girl. Off of her water last night, so that's good. I can see a little better on the camera. Because she had problems with him last night, being in this jug that's a little narrower than a typical jug is actually pretty good. It's longer than normal. The reason why we built it this way is it's actually set up so that if we, let's say, had a milk cow, or if we needed to get our heifer in here or something, it's big enough that we can put her in here and as a little chute or a stanchion or something like that. It does not have a head gate, but that is something that we could add in the future if we needed to, but it's just the right width for a big beef cow to come in if we need them to. So that is why we have this set up at this width, and it seems to be working out really well. Because she wasn't accepting him last night. She was headbutting him and almost attacking him. And so I'm very glad that they were forced into these nice tight quarters. Otherwise, she probably would have just walked off and just left him. You're doing good. You're doing very good, Pebbles. I'm very proud of you. Not that you care, but I am very proud of you. Your little boy is just absolutely beautiful. I love that light brown coat. Mm-hmm. Fleece. So now over here we have Maddie, and that little one there is her ram. The little one here is her ewe. Alfalfa is kind of like a high value treat for them, And so we gave them alfalfa last night. Hello, Maddie. And we're giving it again today. And probably for quite a bit while we handle the lambs and that kind of stuff, because we want to make sure they're super friendly and they're handled from right from the start. And so we're just going to keep giving mom alfalfa so that they hopefully understand that this is a good thing. They do seem to like the cubes better, but the pellets also they like, and it forces the pellets force them to get closer to you. Or if you have the alfalfa cubes, they'll like pull it out with their teeth and not get as close. So I should probably put it right there. So this is the little. It's okay, Mama. There you go. This is the little ram. He is an entire pound smaller than Pebble's ram. Yeah, you're okay. And I can already see his little horn nub, so cute. And he is just tiny, and his fleece is curly up here. Oh, he is absolutely adorable. Yeah. And his spots are like a grayish brown, but his face has some tricolor on it. So he's going to be a badger like his mama. And his tummy feels nice and full. His ears feel pretty warm. They're not absolutely frozen. And his mouth is warm and he's nice and wet. So he's doing, his mouth is nice and wet. So he's doing great. I've been watching these guys nurse. They're nursing a lot. Now, this is the ewe. And she looks like she's doing good too. She's nursing all the time. And her face is still kind of crusty. Didn't get cleaned off the best. Kind of mucky. Anyways, her fleece is so much longer than his. And it's surprising. But she's doing great too. Yeah, both of them are. Now on the little buckling, his hooves right here are bent in. I'd grab him again, but he's back behind her, and I don't want to... Oh, and he has some meconium coming out, so that's good. So he's got his first poop, from what I can see. They're doing great. So his knuckles are bent in, and it's something I'm just watching. It could be a selenium deficiency, but it could also be that he's the smaller of the ones, and he was, like, bent up more. So I'm just giving him a day just to see. They do look a lot better than they did last night, and he's getting around fine on it, but in a few days we might have to start splinting. So I will keep an eye on that and contact the people we bought them from, and then contact our vet too and see what she thinks. She is coming out for an exam on a wellness exam. So I would like to, if possible, wait for her to come out until then. Miss Pepe, we're waiting for you. When are those babies coming? We thought you'd be first. Yeah, you're kind of crazy. We thought for sure you'd be first. So as you can see, everybody seems to be doing really well. And we are just really, really, really lucky. And I feel really good, even though we had to pull that one last night. He's healthy, he's big, he's vigorous. It is really good to see. And it was a bummer to walk out and have a good 4 or 5 inches of snow. And it was really cold. It got in the teens last night. So it was kind of a disappointment to run out in this. But it worked out well. And that this weird front that just came through is probably why they started going into labor. So I've been watching the barometric pressure, and sure enough, there was a big drop yesterday. So that, I'm sure, plays a big key in it. But that's it for today's video. Thanks for tuning in, guys, and we will see you next time. And follow us along. We'd love it if you'd subscribe to our channel, ring that notification bell, and we'll keep you posted on Pepe and if she is going into labor soon, too. See you guys next time.